All right, Chuck, thank you. Now to our top story this morning. Southern Grant County was hit hard by flooding. Several roads remain closed. Near Potosi, firefighters had to rescue some people trapped by the quickly rising water. NBC 15's Chris Woodard is here with more. Chris.
Yeah, Dave, the damages here are widespread. Water ripped apart roads and sent one family scurrying to the top of their house when they realized they were trapped and couldn't get out.
Piece by piece, Larry Ames is salvaging what he can. Inches of mud still cover the road in front of his house, and inside it's not much better. When the water started rising early this morning, he and his wife didn't stand a chance.
By the time we've seen the water in the yard, it's too late. You got to get moving. But we were a little bit too late, and we couldn't get the car out of the garage or out of the driveway. And
the flood had trapped them on the second level of their home.
It started that the water was at their ankles, and a couple seconds later it was at their thighs, and before they knew it, it was at chest level.
Chief Todd Gerhards in the Potosi Fire Department rushed to help, and when the water began dropping, they safely got them out.
The standing water on the road was so high it prevented people from up the hill getting out at all. And if you walk over to Larry's shed, you can see just how high things got. It's a good couple inches over my head.
It just makes a mess out of everything. You can see all the damage, you know, and it takes time to get it all cleaned up and money.
Flooded basements are damaging homes throughout the county. At the National Brewery Museum in Potosi, they're pumping out 12,000 gallons an hour.
Well, we really worry about the power going out because we only have one gas pump.
Just up the road in Dickeyville, Hillclimb Park is completely underwater. You can barely see the top of this sign. Highway crews are replacing washed-out portions of roads and areas next to bridges. And county highways O, B, and U are all closed with water and debris over the roadway. But as bad as things were for the Ames, emergency officials are thankful it wasn't worse. And a quick cleanup is all it's taking in some areas.
Now, the Potosi Fire Chief says a lot of the flood mitigation projects they put in after 2008 did their jobs this morning perfectly because they prevented water from rising above the curbs in downtown Potosi.